Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, I will ban all usage of Boolean parameters to function. Stay tuned to learn why. So on the screen now, you see a QSlider. The QSlider is from Qt3. Feel free to pause while you have a look at it. What exactly does it do? Well, let me tell you. The slider goes from 10 to 100. That is, the value changed will bring a number between 10 and 100 out. It has nothing to do with pixels. The page step is 5, meaning if I click outside of the knob, but still in the slide, of course, then I will jump 5 steps every time. The current value is 20. It's a vertical slider. The parent of the slider is this, and it has an object name called my slider. Super obvious, right? Well, let's look at what it looks like in Qt4, Qt5, and Qt6. Here I write QSlider, new QSlider, it's a vertical slider, and this is the parent. The range goes from 10 to 100, the page step is 5, the value is 20, and the object name, in case you want that, is my slider. Much more readable, right? You gotta love the irony in that in Qt3 days, the marketing slogan from Trolltech was code less, and then they went to Qt4 where you need to code much more. But the key takeaway is that you will write the code once, but you'll read it over and over again. So this one up here is much more error prone than this we have down here. So therefore, I like this one much better. And it leads me to the next example. So in the Qt3 days, you could also write update false. What would that mean? Do not update. So update false, do something, update true. Did that mean disable updating, do that thing and then update? No, it meant do not erase the background. And that's where I'm starting to get to my point. Let's get rid of all those pesky Booleans. That means do this or that, because it's so difficult to read. It's super easy to write false or true when you know exactly what to write. But let's instead go over to Booleans. From Booleans to Enums, that's what I'm trying to say. So instead of update false, it should say update erase background as the enum value, or update do not erase background. That would be much easier. Of course, in Qt4, they threw away the whole idea with erasing the background, but that's a different story. Actually, in the notes below, there is a link to a very good article that was written in the Qt3 days on API design. That's where I got these two examples from, and worthwhile having a read. Oh, come on, Jesper, I've never done something as stupid as that. Really? Okay, I have done that enormous amount of times, but over the years I learned not to do it anymore. And in code reviews these days, if I see a Boolean parameter, I'll tell them, please do rewrite that to an enum and watch this episode on Qt. Well, I'll say that going forward. Let me show you some code where I've done exactly this. It's a bit simplified, but nevertheless. So in this code here, you can see that I have this setup plot method for setting up some graphing or whatever. And I can either show the plots as year on year, meaning that the plot axis go from January to December, and then I see a 2020, 2021, and 2022 plots in there, or it can be just a continuous one. And with a continuous one, I will just see from over here to over here, reversed for your viewing, I will see the from January 2020 to December 22 instead. Which of these do I do? Well, depending on this Boolean. So setup plot false, again, do not setup plot. Let's see a better solution. The better solution is to use an enum. Enum class plot type year on year or continuously. And then it says setup plot, plot type colon colon year on year. Much easier to read. Can you please start agreeing a bit with me? You still do not see the problem with setup plot false? Well, imagine there were three parameters, three enums. So it would say, do prepare for the party, false, false, true. What does that mean? So here we have a party. Make ice, brew coffee, and open beers. And depending on which of those, it'll print out yes or no to make ice, brew coffee, and open beers. But that's not the key thing. The key thing is in my party. Party, false, false, true. We all agree, I hope, that that is not very readable. And it's easy to get the make ice or brew coffee or whatever to get that moved around. So here's the solution for that problem. Let's have an enum instead. And actually, let's make that into some bitwise or flag. That's magic with Qt flags. So here I have my enum party options. It's a boring party. Make ice, brew coffee, and open beers. And notice that these are bits. So 1, 2, 4, 8, 10, 20, 40, 80. That's the right way of counting to 100. And here we have declare flags party. So party options, that's my party option as a flag. And I declare these operators for it. And now I can go down here and use the operator. So make ice, if my options, that's my party options given here, if my options and single ampersand make ice, then yes, brew coffee and so on. And now my party enum is much more easy to read. Party, brew coffee, or open beers, all means and, well, gee. Anyway, brew coffee and open beers. Let me show you another example of this. It's, remember the DepecheModel that I've shown you multiple times? It's showing a table with the release albums of DepecheMode, and it shows whether they were released on LP or CD or download and so on. And the code for that looked like this. It was just some test data that I created, but you could see here it says true, 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 false, false, false. And what that came from was my mData where I had Boolean for CD, for cassette tapes, for LPs and so on. Now, I rewrote that, and just go over here. I rewrote that to use these enums instead, and my data now looks like this all the way up here. You can see Speak and Spell was released on CD, cassette tapes, and on LP, and this is much, much more readable. The code for this, I simply created this namespace medium, and I needed to be in a namespace, can't be global for this qdeclare flag thing working out, but I created it in a namespace called medium here, and here on my bitwise flag again, 1, 2, 4, 8, 10, and mediums. And now instead of all these, not down here, instead of all these booleans, I simply have mediums, medium here, that I can do the bitwise on. The hardest part of this was really to rewrite all these true and false to look like this, but I hope you agree with me that this is much more readable.
Hey, Jesper, why do you even listen to that guy? Who are you? Who I am? I'm your future you, of course. The future and more wise you. So I've been pondering a bit about this whole Boolean thing since you recorded that video. And you know what? There are actually situations where Booleans are perfectly okay. Let me just give you three examples from Qt itself. So the first one, do you really want set enabled on Qt widgets to be enable colon colon yes, enable colon colon no? Of course you don't. Set enabled true or set enabled false, perfectly okay API. That's also my favorite one, set autofill background. That's the one that you always, when you want to change the color, so you change the palette and you forget to set this one and nothing works. Love that one. Set autofill background. That should have been set autofill background mode with fill background and do not fill background or paint background or whatever enum you would call that. Set autofill background true. That reads just as well. And finally, we saw these flags with brew coffee and open beers. We bitwise ored them together. And that, of course, you could have created the flags object yourself and then just set flag. So create my flag object and then dot set flag open beer comma true set flag brew coffee comma false to make that explicit that you shouldn't brew coffee. And that, of course, the comma true and comma false, these Boolean option there, perfectly okay. On the larger line, I still agree with you, but there are, as always, corner cases like this that trips you over. And back to you. On that note, thank you for listening to me once again. I'm Jesper Pedersen from QTopia, and you've been watching Qt Widgets and more.
Wait, there's more. On June 13th to 15th, QTopia is gonna host a Qt developer conference in Berlin, in person. I'll be there, and I hope you'll be there too. Check out the program below. Trust me, there is gonna be something super interesting for widgets developers too.